and did the complete opposite. Kenyans responded to this turn of events by trying to steady their businesses, especially the small enterprises. But those efforts were in vain as interest rates rose through the roof and more taxes hit those businesses. Only the government can now afford to borrow at the astronomical rate of 17% or more from the domestic market. In other words, the government is competing in the private sector in the domestic financial market. The result has been that micro and small businesses are struggling, defaulting, and folding up, when the larger private sector is at best stagnating or equally folding up. In the last 1 year, the proportion of micro and small businesses defaulting on loans has increased by 17%. Today, 6 out of 10 micro and small businesses are either paying late, paying only a part of their installment, or are unable to pay. Inflation is driven by the cost of food and fuel. As long as the government has not resolved the price of food and fuel, the cost of living will not come down. No amount of fertilizer will lower the cost of food as long as the cost of fuel is unchecked. Diesel is one of the highest costs in farming. Even if you give the citizen a bag of fertilizer, but make it impossible for her or him to plow an acre of land, you have not solved the problem. The shilling taking the grains like maize, wheat and rice that we import, those commodities have increased by 25%. As the economy has suffered, another grand betrayal of dreams has unfolded silently in the education sector. As a party, we believe that we cannot neglect education no matter the magnitude of the economic challenges we are grappling with. We believe that if we are not to spend just one, if we are to spend just on one thing, it should be education. In 1 year, Kenya Kwanza has thrown the education sector into a deep financial crisis. In public, Kenya Kwanza administration continues to talk about free education. The reality in our schools and homes across Kenya is that education is no longer free, either in primary or secondary schools. Inadequate funding is growing into a full-blown crisis in primary and secondary schools, forcing head teachers to beg from well-wishers to help finance schools, straining parents further, and threatening the high enrollment reached in recent years as many students are sent home for school fees. Although academic year is coming to an end, the funds that have been released to schools are way below what was required. In some of the schools, the government has disbursed as low as 15,000 shillings for a student population of 400. Some schools received as low as Kenya shillings 3,000. We are, however, very concerned that under the Kenya Kwanza, education and the country are getting compromised by mismanagement, lack of clarity, lack of interest, and weak leadership in the sector.